In today's Illustrator text tutorial, I have four ways you can use gradients on text in Illustrator. What is up, people? Welcome back to the home of graphic design content on YouTube, Satori Graphics. I have an Illustrator text tutorial today. We're going to be looking at four cool ways to use gradients on text. As I mentioned at the start of the week, I'm finding myself with less time lately, so I'm down to four videos per week, making today's tutorial the last one of this week. The first way we can use gradients on text is the most simplest method in today's tutorial. I like to outline my text in Illustrator when editing in this way. We then need to add a gradient fill here. If you don't have the gradient window open, you can do so here. Add the colors to your gradient in the gradient window, which by default should be set to linear. To make sure the gradient is fluid over the entire text, grab the gradient tool and draw a line across the text by holding down shift. We can change the direction of the gradient in the window as well. Now let's take a look at the radial gradient, which we can select here. This time with the gradient tool, we can drag it from the center of the text and then outwards to add the gradient effect. For the next effect in this Illustrator text tutorial, open up the appearance window. It's always best to add a stroke to your text in this window rather than doing it in the palette. Add a new stroke and then move the stroke layer behind the fill layer, and add a color fill. To remove issues like this here, open up the stroke window and round off the edges. With the stroke layer selected, add a gradient fill to it. It can be a radial or linear, as both will work. This text effect can be really cool when made in Illustrator. The third text effect in today's tutorial uses spheres to make up a gradient. So go ahead and create a sphere with the ellipse tool and add a gradient to it. We then need to use the rotate tool, so drag the target icon down to the bottom point, and click once and then hold down the Alt Option key. Type in 90 degrees and then hit copy. Once you've copied it, press Command or Control D to repeat it two more times. Then place your text over the spheres and open the Pathfinder window. In the Pathfinder window, we need to use the crop operation. The last way to use gradients on text in Illustrator is adding shadows with gradients. Using the pen tool, we can add a section that will represent a shadow, making the text look more 3D and that much more cooler. Add a gradient to the section and then make it a linear gradient. On one side, make the color similar to the text but a darker shade. And then on the other side, lower the opacity down to zero. For the side of the gradient that is set to zero opacity, you can select the original text layer, go in and copy the RGB color code. Once copied, go back to the shadow gradient and paste the code into the RGB section. This will make the gradient blend more along your text. So did you find today's Illustrator text tutorial helpful? Let me know in the comment section below and drop a like on your way out. Share this video if you find it really helpful, and have a great weekend everyone, because this is the last upload from me this week. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.